Hi there, everybody. In the summer of 2018, Gamemaker finally released their virtual keyboard functions. So now, Gamemaker finally has a built-in system for handling the on-screen keyboard for both iOS and Android. The most important function is probably their keyboard virtual show. This function takes four arguments. Keyboard type, return key type, auto calculation type, and predictive text enabled. We're going to have a closer look at keyboard type and return key type. First off, the keyboard type. There's quite a few different ones to pick from, but this is what they all look like on iOS or the iPhone. You got a default one. It's pretty much a standard keyboard that every iOS user is used to. You also have the ASCII one. The difference from the default type is that the smiley or emoji button is missing. And you have the URL type, where the spacebar is gone altogether and have been replaced with a dot, slash, and .com. Then you have the email type. The space key is smaller and giving space to the at key and dot key. For the numbers type, just showing the numbers. The type phone is showing the numbers and also the plus, star, and hash or pound key. The type phone name looks very similar to the default one, but once you hit the numbers key, in left corner, it gives you something very similar to the phone type. That's the iOS keyboards. Let's have a look at the Android ones. Here we have the same types, but as you can see, many of them are pretty much the same keyboard. The default one, the ASCII one, and the URL one is pretty much the same one, and the email and phone name one is the same one. The numbers and the phone keyboard look a lot different. That's worth keeping in mind if you want to write a single code that's going to handle both Android and iOS. Then you have the return key. Here I've taken a picture of every single return key on iOS and Android. Altogether, there are 12 to choose from. But if you have a closer look, you're going to see that the Google one, the search one, and the Yahoo one yields the same button on both iOS and Android. On iOS, it's the search button, and on Android, it's going to be the magnifying glass button. But if you take a closer look at the Android ones, you see the same button reoccurring multiple times. The default key and the done key is the same one, it's a check mark. The go key is the same for go, join, roots, and emergency call. The next key is the same for next and continue. And finally, you have the send key, which is unique. But again, if you want to create a single code base for both Android and iOS, you can see that you have these five keys that matches on both platforms. There's nothing wrong using the join key, as GameMaker will translate this into the go key for you. But altogether, you only have five different keys, return keys, on Android. Let's have a look at a couple of tips on how to use the keyboards. But first, if you like my videos, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Really handy function is that the virtual keyboards write to the keyboard string. That way, whatever you type in on the keyboard is going to be stored at the keyboard string. And what's even more beautiful is that when you hit backspace, it's going to erase from the string. One tip, if you want the return key to close down the keyboard, then you check the key ORD 10, because the return key returns the ORD 10 value, which is the new line. So if or 10 is pressed, that's the return key. Then you can go ahead and hide the keyboard. In GameMaker, it's much harder to make a text box than doing it online, because you have no function called text box. You can do as here, make a sprite that looks like a text box and just draw text in the middle of it. But as you soon can see, this has a major disadvantage once the text becomes wider than the box. You can handle this in GameMaker by masking the box. If there's any interest on how to do that, please leave a comment and I'll make a video of it. So this is an easy workaround. Instead of having a text box, you could just do this line where you can write on the line, because then you can fit a lot more text in there. And voila! Now you're up and running with a virtual keyboard on both iOS and Android. Happy coding! And do remember to subscribe.